lovelies. Welcome, hello, my lovelies. Welcome back to my channel. For those of you guys that are new, welcome. My name is Pinky, and teaching you witchcraft and tarot is what I do. For those of you guys returning, welcome back, my loves. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you guys can get notified of the most recent videos going up. We have tons of new spell videos going up and how-tos, as well as tarot readings, so that we can kick off the new year. So here's another spell for you guys. This is a spell that is extremely powerful. It is a very simplistic spell that anyone can do. And it is preferred to do this at the end of the year going into the new year. So you want to start this off between the 21st of December going into the 25th of December and moving forward. So you want to kind of use that time frame so that you can be able to begin this process. Like I said, it's a very simplistic spell. All you need is paper, pen, and a jar, and that's it. The intention. As always, if you do this with faith, you're going to be amazed at the results that you get. And like I said, I will give you the step-by-step on how to do this. It's very simplistic. I want to wish all of you guys happy holidays, and let's get into the video. Hello, my lovelies. Welcome back to my channel. For those of you guys that are new, welcome. My name is Pinky, and teaching you witchcraft and tarot is what I do. For those of you guys returning, welcome back, my loves. I hope you didn't think that I would leave you guys alone for Christmas Eve. So here we are doing a spell for you guys that it is extremely powerful. You guys are going to be amazed at the results. This is an end of year type of spell. It's very easy, very simplistic, like I said, but extremely powerful. Now, for those of you guys that are new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you guys can get notified of the most recent videos going up. We have tons of spells for New Year's as well as to kick off the new year. You also stay tuned for the videos for every single zodiac sign. We're going to go into the predictions for 2024. Let's get into it. What is it that you're going to need? Very simple, you guys. You're going to need a mason jar. You're going to need a pen and paper. Now, you can use any type of paper. Doesn't matter. If you don't have a pen, you can use a marker. Doesn't matter. It is about intention here. I prefer for you guys to use a white candle, as this is going to help you set the mood and also direct the energy and focus towards the intent that we're doing here. This is known in the pagan community. It is a pagan spell that was taught to me many years ago. And every single time I've done it at the end of the year, it gives me amazing results. Now, I do want to tell you guys, do not make the mistakes that I've done in the past when doing this spell. Sometimes I get so wrapped up into preparing myself for the new year that I do spell work back to back. And I think it was 2 years ago when I did the spell. It was not my first time. I had received amazing results. I've been doing this, I want to say, for about 7 or 8 years now. But 2 years ago, it was when we experienced massive growth, and I wish I could have written down exactly what I had petitioned, as it's really difficult when you don't do this. So again, don't skip this step. Like I said, you need a mason jar, a pen, and paper. Now, you ideally want to use two pages of paper. Why? You're going to be writing down 13 wishes, okay? These are 13 manifestations that you're trying to draw into your life for the new year. Now, ideally, obviously, a year is 12 months. We're going to be making 13 wishes, okay? We're going to be writing down 13 petitions. Keep it as short and simplistic and to the point as possible, okay? We don't want to scatter our energy. We don't want to try the best you can. I know this is something I often get told from you guys, the feedback that I get from you guys when doing spell work, that sometimes you get so wrapped up in the process that you kind of forget or skip a step, etc. Try the best you can to watch this video, to do it the way I'm telling you to do it. but get to the point basically when asking for the petitions. Don't write paragraphs. The more simplistic, the easier it is and the quicker you will see results. Like I said, this is a pagan ritual that is done at the end of the year, winter solstice. You can do this between the 21st all the way to ideally the 27th of December so that you can go into the new year already in the process of this spell, okay? If you watch this video, let's say at the middle of the year, let's say you see this spell and it's June. And let's say your birthday is in October or it's in July, then you can still do this spell, okay? Return of the sun, meaning when your birthday is around that time, this spell is also ideal. Why? Because it is the whole, when you are experiencing your birthday, it's almost like you've gained a new year, you're going into a new year. So again, if your birthday is around the end or the middle of the month, the middle of the year, you can still do the spell. Now, if your birthday is in the beginning of the year, you want to make sure that you start off this this spell. Like I said, it is ideally to kick off the new year with intention, with focus and determination towards what we're calling in. Now, like I said, obviously a year takes 12 months. The 13th wish or intent, I will tell you guys why we're doing that, okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to get a piece of paper and you're going to write down 13 wishes, like I said, 13 intentions, 13 manifestations that you're trying to experience, okay? You're going to go down, try the best you can to have a bit of a space because we're going to be cutting, these petitions. Let me do this really quick. I'm just doing this, you guys, for purposes. We've already kicked it off, but I'm doing this for showing purposes so that you guys can see. And like I said, if you do this with intent and you do this with focus, you're going to be amazed at the results, okay? This is something that it's proof, okay? Proven. This is something that I encourage, you know, clients, I encourage family members to do, and it is amazing, and you're going to be thrown aback at the results that you get, okay? Like I said, ideally, I do wish that you get, the candle's not necessary, however, you want to make sure that you're tapping and pulling in the energies that are necessary in order to manifest this with no issue and no resistance. And obviously the element of fire is very strong, very powerful, and very quick. So again, that's the reason why I always use this white candle. And I say this candle because in this process, when you're writing down your petitions, you're going to light the candle and you can snuff it out once it's done and once the papers have been introduced in the jar. Now, if you really want to empower this spell, whatever candle that you use, once you snuff it out, put it away and you can save it for next year, the following year. If you're doing this process again, you light that same candle. By us putting intention and energy into what we're doing, it becomes more strong and more powerful, which is, this is why I'm using this mason jar. This is a jar I've been using for about a good 5 or 6 years now, for anything that has to do with manifestations. And I only use it for that. Why? Because the more energy you put into your work, the more focus and determination you're aligning yourself to what you're welcoming into your life. And by using the tools that are going to help you facilitate that, it just makes it so much more easier. And like I said, you're going to be blown the fuck away when you see the results. Like I said, it was a few years ago that I did this spell and I was like, I'm not going to need to write it down. It is what it is. I'm putting it out to the universe and whatever comes from it will come. And everything, I can almost swear by it. Everything that I had put on there manifested. And sometimes we need our brain, right? It needs to catch up to the manifestations of things because our unconscious, you know, or subconscious, I should say, takes a while, right? So when we see these manifestations, it's validation of what you're doing and the power behind it. So I really regretted that year that I didn't write it down on two different papers so that later on in the year, I can look back at it and pretty much check off everything that had manifested for me. So again, I do encourage you guys, don't skip that step because you're going to be blown away. All right. So once, as you guys can see here, I have already done that. We wrote from 1 to 13. You're going to make 13 wishes, 13 intents, 13 experiences, or 13 things that you're trying to manifest into your life. You're going to write down as it has already happened. So as an example, if you're trying to make a certain amount of money a month, you're going to write down, I am blessed and thankful. And then you're going to put the amount that I'm making a month. To the point, short and sweet, okay? It could be as simplistic as an example, you can write down $10,000 a month in income. Number two, it can be if you're trying to get a new car, if you know exactly the type of car that you want, you're gonna write that down, and so on, okay? You're gonna go all the way to 13. Once you do that, what you're gonna do is you're going to do the same. You're gonna copy these intentions, right? These petitions on another piece of paper, and ideally use a journal so that you can go back at the end of the year, like I said, and check mark or check off everything that has already came into fruition for you. So that's the reason why we use two papers. Very important. Don't skip that step if you really want to be amazed. Okay. All right. Once that is done, you're going to cut the papers as such. You're going to cut the papers in a strip and you're going to fold it. Okay, before you put it into the jar, I want you to take a couple of seconds or a couple of minutes saying out loud the petition, what you're asking for, and really hone into that energy. Really feel, how does it feel what you're asking for? Once you have it, once it's already manifested for you, how are you feeling? Get into that vibration. When you feel that you're excited and you're looking forward to the new year, then you're going to put them in the mason jar, okay? Once that's done, like I said, if you follow my instructions, hopefully you do, you write down all the petitions in a separate piece of paper or on a journal so that you can be able to look back, okay? Once that's done and once you have put all the petitions in the mason jar, what we're going to do now is you're going to take a couple of minutes holding the jar, holding the petitions that are in the jar, and you're going to thank the universe. I thank you, universe, for the blessings that have been bestowed upon me. I thank my spirit guides. I thank my ascended masters for allowing me to align myself to my highest purpose. I am blessed and I am thankful for the blessings that are being bestowed upon me now. Everything is working out in my favor and everything is in aligning or in alignment to bring to me as quickly, as effortlessly, and as quickly as possible with no resistance whatsoever. I am open to receiving, I am thankful, and I am blessed. Once you do that, you're going to snuff the candle out. And what we're going to do now is the process is a 12-day ritual. So once you have done that, what you're going to do is you're going to shake up the jar and you're going to pull out one strip of paper. Okay. Now, you're not going to read what is in that paper. So you don't know the petition that is on this strip of paper. Okay. You're going to pull out the petition and you're going to burn it, okay? You're going to burn the petition. And when you burn this petition paper, you know that it is out in the universe. It is no longer in your, you know, it's no longer in just stored in your energy. It is out in the universe. It is working itself out. Give me one second, you guys. I'm so sorry. It is no longer your concern or your worry how this is going to come to you. Once you burn this paper, it is out. Think of it as it is a, It is a ball of energy that the moment you burn it, the moment the smoke comes out, it is out into the universe. It is out into every single dimension, every single parallel dimension to bring to you, you know, that petition. So it is crucial and important for you guys not to read the petition. You're just going to burn it, okay? Once you burn it, you're going to thank the spirits. You're going to say, thank you, spirit guides. Thank you, ascended masters. Thank you, my ancestors, for blessing me. I am now receiving this. I receive it with an open mind and open heart, and I am excited and thrilled. Once you do that, you're going to put your mason jar away, keep it in your altar, keep, or if you want to do it like me, most of my petitions have always been specifically for this jar is for manifestations that have to do with growth, advancement, and my career. So what I do is I keep it in my desk. Okay. So the next day, meaning the following day, you're going to do the same process. You're going to get this strip of paper, another strip of paper, and you're going to burn it. The moment you burn it, know without a doubt that it is not your duty. It is not your problem. It is not for you to know how it's going to come or what is going to come because you don't know. You know what you asked for, but you don't know what's coming to you. Okay. So once you burn it, again, you do the same process. You thank your spirits. You thank the universe. You put your jar away. I will put it in my desk. And the next day, I'm going to do the same thing. You're going to do this process, this whole process. You're going to do it for 12 days. Now, you remember I said we're going to do 13 petitions, right? So there is one that's going to be left. Once the 12 days are over, on your 13th day, you're going to pull out the last strip of paper and you're going to open it. When you open it, whatever you asked for, whatever it says on that strip of paper, it is no longer up to the universe. It is up to you to make that shit happen. So as an example, you burn all your petitions. This is a 12-day ritual. On the 13th day, you're going to pull out the last strip of paper, but you're going to read it this time. You're going to open it up and you're going to read it. Whatever it says, it is up to you. So basically, you are aligning yourself to receive what the universe is bringing to you. But on the last process, meaning on the last day, it is up to you to make that happen, whatever it is. Okay? So what we're doing here is we're setting ourselves up for success, for manifestation, and to receive those manifestations. But at the end of the process, the last strip of paper that you're going to open and you're going to read out loud, that is up to you. Think of it, it's going to be your way of giving the universe a token of gratitude, a token of an offering. You've given me all of this and I will put my two cents in to make this happen for me. There is power behind that, you guys. So again, it is simple. Stick to it. You cannot skip a day. So make sure that every single day, if you're the type that gets really, really busy, like I do, the morning I start my day, the moment I wake up, the moment I go to the restroom, wash my teeth, do what I have to do, I always early in the morning light my candles to my saint and give gratitude to my ancestors. So that's when I burn my papers because I know that we can get wrapped up in life. Things happen and sometimes we gotta run. Sometimes we're running late, whatever it is. But you cannot skip a day. You have to do this back to back. On the 13th day, like I said, you're gonna pull out the last strip of paper. Whatever it says there, it is up to you to make that happen. You burn it and you thank spirit and you thank your ancestors and you thank the universe. You will go into the new year with such empowerment, with such strength that everything is going to align for you. and you're going to be amazed at the results, you guys. If you do this, come back, comment below, let me know how it went for you guys. You guys are going to be blown away. Like I said, do it always with faith, intention, and focus. I want to wish you guys happy holidays. Do not despair. We have tons of new spells coming through, as well as readings for you. I will see you guys soon. Till then, happy holidays, everyone, and we will see each other soon. Bye.